pure fentanyl, it is fire. Like, it is so dangerous. It's like the most horrid, wretched, pure terror you can imagine. And it feels like something slowly, like, just pulling your life force out of you.
2,250 Kentuckians died from drug overdoses last year. That's up 14.5% compared to the year prior.
Continues to wreak havoc in our communities as it quickly becomes the most common drug involved in overdose death.
It is the leading cause of death for Americans ages 18 to 45, and it can kill people who don't even know that they are taking it.
Where fentanyl is the most addictive and deadly drug in the United States.
Lucas was my son. I had 1,000 things I wanted to say, but before I start, this is a club that I never wanted to be a member of. You're always thinking it'll never happen to you.
We are definitely going to keep spreading awareness. Absolutely. Every single year.
Every year, y'all will hear
and
us.
And get this off our streets and out of our town, because it does not need to belong here.
I don't know why God always takes the good ones first. And man, I've tried to be strong and carry on, but damn, this hurts. And I just wish that I could talk to you again somehow, some way. Even if it's for a moment, so I can hear you say, don't cry for me, I'm alright. I'm better than you know. And this life can be a shorter ride, so don't waste it on sorrow. Just hold on to those moments and the memories we shared. We're both headed for the same place anyway. I just beat you there. I know they say, just give it a little time. That might be true. It don't really help me today. And we ain't supposed to question the man upstairs, but there's just so much I don't understand. It just don't seem fair. Don't cry for me, I'm all. I just beat you there. And as each day goes by, I get a little bit stronger. But that don't stop me from wishing you were here a little bit longer. Whoa, whoa, and I know you're watching over me and everything I do.
first of all, I want to say thank you so much for all the love and support that we have gotten through all of this. I know myself, Kayla, Luke's family, his mom especially, is extremely grateful for everything that y'all have done, the love, the support, the donations, because this cause is so important and it has taken so many lives. And I'm not really trying to get emotional, but it's just a really hard thing to deal with. And when you lose somebody, when it comes to this, it's not fun and it needs to be stopped. It's getting out here in our community and it's killing people that we love, and it's just, it's not fair. It's really not fair. Luke didn't deserve this, and neither did anybody else that y'all had lost. I am gonna stop speaking for a second because it is an emotional time and I don't know if I can get all the way through it. But I am gonna play a song that Luke's mom wanted to play. And it's also not only just dedicated to her son, but is also to all the ones that y'all have lost as well too, because y'all just wanna know the answer why yourselves. After she has done with her song, she's gonna come up and give her perspective on what it's like to be a mother of a lost child to this drug. And then I will have Kayla come up and she will give her all her information about fentanyl and what it does and how dangerous it is and the awareness that you need to keep it away from your kids and your family. After that, we will proceed the walk downtown around. We'll be escorted by the Hopkinsville Police Department. We will come back here afterwards and you guys can enjoy the vendors and enjoy everybody, get to know everyone. And I hope this event turns out really great. We will have this walk every year until we can't stop no more. So I hope you all enjoy it.
Hello, my name is Sharon, and Lucas was my son. I had 1,000 things I wanted to say, but before I start, this is a club that I never wanted to be a member of. You always think it'll never happen to you. Hold your kids, love them, and tell them you love them every day, because you don't know when it's going to be time that you're going to be with your child. I want you to know my son, you know, is not defined by his addiction. That was just a disease he had. My son was loving. He loved with all his heart. He was, Mother's Day, he would go out of his way to make sure I had a good day. I love him. I miss him. I want to tell you how, when this started, I was in the hospital with my other son in Louisville, and I was laying on a hospital bed beside my other son, and I got a call, and I'm like, Jenny Stewart is calling me. Are they calling me into work? And I'm like, it was weird. So I didn't answer it. I said, I'll call him back when I wake up, because it was like 5 Louisville time. And but then they called back a second time, and I'm like, I better get this. Well, it was the coroner, and I'm friends with her. And so I'm like, Christy, it's Lucas, isn't it? And she's like, yeah. So she proceeded to tell me that he was gone. And I'm like, and I couldn't, you know, somebody needed to go identify him. And I'm like, I can't. I'm three hours away in Louisville. But so I'm trying to get a hold of family to do that. And it's still surreal to me. I can't believe that I'm not going to see his face again. I just want you to know that if me being here will help one person not to die from this disease, please get the help you need. There's treatment centers out here. Go talk to who you need to talk to, because life is short. There's help out there if you want it. So if you have that problem, please reach out to some of these treatment centers, because it's no joke out there now. It just one time could be it. And people, moms have come to me, and it seems to be the consensus that the moms have said to me that their son was clean a year, and he does one pill, and that's it, relapses. So just please, if you have this problem, get the help you need, because I don't want to see no mother go through this, because this is a hurt like you can't even imagine. And I do want to say before I finish, to all the people out there that has helped me, there are so many I can't even name. Mary, my grief counselor, is helping me with grief. Jan, that has lost a son to this disease too. And Diana, my work family, have been awesome to me. And all these other people that I can't even, Kara has called me constantly, worried about me. And I can't tell you what it means to me for the people that's reached out to me and that has helped me on this horrible journey that I'm going through. I can't even imagine. I couldn't till it hit me. And it's just, it's nothing I ever wish on anybody. So like I said, if there's anyone that is struggling, go to some of these treatment centers that sit up out here and talk to them. Talk to them, please. Because it's not fair to have any mother, father, or anybody ever go through this. Thank you.
I just want to say something really quick. I know that Kayla's going to come up and she's going to talk about fentanyl, but Miss Daphne Smith lost her daughter as well, and I wanted to know if she wanted to come up and say something about her. You don't? Okay. Well, like I said earlier, when we all started this, we started this because Luke passed away and it was a horrible thing. And I just want to make this 100% clear. This drug is not fun. And I invited a lot of teenagers to come, including my own, because I have two beautiful teenage daughters. One's a high school senior and one's a freshman. And I know that they like to go and they like to hang out with their friends and stuff, but it's so easily influenced. So please talk to your kids every single day. Check their social medias, everything. I'm telling you, it's horrible. It's horrible. I just had to get that off of my chest because I have to say this to my kids all the time. It's not fun. And I don't want another mother or father, brother, sister, another family member to get a phone call from the sheriff's office where you have to come and identify your kid. It's not fun.
My name is Kayla and I'm the co-founder of This Walk. Today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about things you might not know about fentanyl. In 2022, 2,135 people died from fentanyl in Kentucky alone. Someone dies from fentanyl about every 11 minutes, around 150 people every day. That's over 50,000 people in the United States that's dying from this drug. 72% of the people who have passed away from fentanyl are from the ages of 12 to 45. Now I know when I saw that age 12, I was like, wow, that's young. Sorry. The thing with fentanyl is it can be made to look like many things. Almost any pill that you can think of, and even candy. There's a new look for some of the fentanyl, and it's called rainbow fentanyl. It's made to look just like candy, and it's being passed around at schools. The new drug dealer for your kids is their phones. There are some things that you can look out for on your children's phone to pay attention to. If you see a plug, a pill, a parking sign, a banana, or a blue circle, those are all symbols for Percocets and oxycodone, but they're not what your kids think they're getting. They're all filled with fentanyl. I know as parents, this is probably really scary to hear. And as a mother of five with four teenagers, it scares me every day. But the more we are educated, the better chance we have of protecting our loved ones. It's time to come together as a community and fight this. We have to be loud and open about this drug. We have to talk about it and listen and not judge the people who have taken it. We have to stand beside each other in our darkest time. I also want to give a big shout out to all the police departments in Kentucky and the EMS for working so hard to get this off the streets. In the past 7 months, Kentucky police departments have gotten 142 pounds of fentanyl off the street. That's a pretty big number. What's scary about that number is that it could kill 28.9 million people. Now I'm going to turn the mic over to my big brother, Jason Willis, who's going to lead us in prayer and give you a little bit of his backstory.
My name is Jason Willis. I've lived around this town most of my life. For over 20 years, I was an addict. I've lost both of my parents to overdose. I actually overdosed twice myself. Thankfully, my wife was there and was able to bring me back before I actually died. And it's only by the grace of God that he was there and he put her in my life. You know, this overdose is no joke. It's becoming a very real epidemic. I mean, Kentucky is in the top 10 for overdose and drugs, you know. And in the state of Kentucky, overdose is the second leading cause of death. You know, and even just touching something that has fentanyl on it, it can get in your system and kill you. So be careful with what you're picking up out here in the parking lots, you know, what somebody's giving you. And for any of y'all, for all the people out here who've lost someone to overdose, I mean, I don't know where you stand with God, but God is a great redeemer and a great healer. You know, he is what has saved my life and completely changed everything around. There was so many years of my life where I just wished and wished and wished for peace, inner peace, and he's the only one who could give it to me. So if any of y'all don't know God, just get to know him. He'll change everything. But if I could get everybody to bow your heads. Lord, we just come to you right now and just pray that you watch over all the people out here who've lost their loved ones to overdose. Just please just be there for the people still in addiction. Just help deliver them from all the demons that they're battling. We know that they don't get on them because they just want to. It's usually to cover something up, you know, to deal with some kind of pain that they're going through. We just pray that you just deliver the people out here from the pain, the anxiety, and the depression that they're going through, Lord. We just pray that you keep them all safe and put a hedge of protection around them as they take this walk, Lord. We just pray that you just continue to work in the ways that only you can do, Lord, and just move in their life as you have mine. We just thank you for all the wonderful and amazing blessings that you have given us, even through all our storms. We just pray that you continue to let them see their blessings, Lord, and let them understand what they still have. In your mighty and wonderful name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
All right, everybody, if she's going to get the public safety officer to head out here, and then we are going to start the walk over here to the right.
You must have been in a place so dark you couldn't feel the light. Reaching for you through that stormy cloud. Now here we are gathered in our little hometown. This can't be the way you meant to draw a crowd. Oh, I, that's what I keep asking. Was there anything I could have said or done? Oh, I had no clue you were masking a troubled soul. God only knows what went wrong and why you leave the stage in the middle of a song. Thank you. shine just like the sun. Oh, I, that's what I keep asking. And was there anything I could have said or done? Oh, I had no clue you were masking a troubled soul. Thoughts I hear a mockingbird sing. This old world really ain't that bad a place. Oh, I, there's no comprehending, and who am I to try to judge or explain?
Given some sponsors to give to Luke's mother, and Miss Kara is going to give that to her now. Y'all can go check out our vendors, hang out, talk to each other, get to know each other.
Hey, can y'all hold that up one more time? No.
Yeah.
Everybody look this way.
No.
Helping your fear, though.
Yeah, I know. That's the side.
Oh my God.
Cut that up.
Like a little bit of it.
So, Miss Kara, how do you feel after you've done the walk?
Well, I was nervous at first, but now I am extremely excited this is done, and I cannot wait to do it next year. I really cannot, and I'm just going to keep, we are definitely going to keep spreading awareness.
Absolutely.
Every single year.
Every year, y'all will hear
and
us.
And get this off our streets and out of our town, because it does not need to belong here anymore.
So what is your main objective and main goal?
To give people the information that they need so they know that it's out there, it's on our streets, it's in pretty much every drug that there is out there. People are taking it without even knowing. We're losing our children, and they don't know why. We don't know why.
Right. And if we can save one, we can save 10. And we're going to keep going.
That's our goal.
We're going to keep going.
That is our goal, to save as many people from this as we can.
If the night
night sky was missing the moon. There were no shooting stars to use wishing on you. And all of my sorrows I just washed them down. It's the only peace I've ever found. All of this drinking and smoking is hopeless, but feel like it's all that I need. So
ready?
Everybody ready? On the count of three, we're gonna let the balloons go. One, two, three.
Baby, don't waste your time.
That was heavy.
That was a little heavy.
I'm so damaged beyond repair.
Life has shattered my hopes and my dreams. I'm a lost cause.
Baby, don't waste your time on me. I'm so damaged beyond repair. Life has shattered my hopes and my dreams.